Hi, I'm Vanessa, and I love bad Star Trek. I break down the bad episodes of my favorite show so you don't have to watch it. I will be the TKO by BO that is Star Trek Voyager. Today, I will be talking to you about an episode called The Fight, which takes place in season 5, and they still have not developed Chakotay's character. Beltran, who played Chakotay, was dissatisfied with this, and the writers thought he regularly phoned in his performances. So it became this feedback loop of Beltran getting pissed that his character was not doing anything significant. So his frustration showed through his performance, which then pissed off the writers, who didn't want to develop his character. There's also an unsubstantiated rumor online that he was actively trying to get fired by asking for more money every time his contract was renegotiated, and they just kept matching his price. But who knows? Anyway, when there is discord in the writer's room between the actors and the writers, it shows in the end product very clearly. Also, any episode that heavily features Chakotay leans into him as a racist stereotype whose job it is to kowtow to a white woman without question. Chakotay's cultural background is that he is a member of the Rubber Tree People, a tribe created by the white writers of the show. And the person they consulted about Native American rituals and beliefs was a fraud named Jamake Highwater, who infamously pretended to be Cherokee. Why they never thought to talk to Beltran himself, who was Latin Dio, is a mystery. So buckle up for more of how white people think Native people's spirituality ought to be depicted on film. I think it is a violent form of erasure to put a white guy's ideas of Native culture in a Native person's mouth. The plot of The Fight itself is indistinct from much of Trek because it involves getting stuck in an anomaly and having to figure out how to get out. Like, whenever being stuck is the height of drama, that is not a good sign. If you put on a shirt whose neck hole is too small and that is the absolute worst thing that happens that day, not a bad day. That happened to me the other day, and I thought it was as though I had become a wide receiver with an Easter Island head. The neck and shoulder area was violently tiny and unyielding, like baby clothes. You ever put on a shirt that's so small that it forces your jaw open? And you know what? Still have the shirt, can't get rid of it. You'd think with a well-worn Star Trek problem, there's no way they could make it confusing, right? Get stuck. Maybe the ship rocks and rolls, figure out the problem, get out. Fairly straightforward, if not boring and predictable. Nope, I legitimately don't understand what the hell is going on. Just like Voyager can't when they can't leave what they call chaotic space, whose gravitational coefficient is altered from that of the rest of space. What I find cool about this particular aspect is that gravitational coefficient is a real thing. Here it is. I don't know what it means. I'm no astronomer, but the universal gravitational constant is constant. So it does logically follow that if it was somehow different, that things could get a little zany. And this episode throws us right into the action, and we see that the ship is stuck in chaotic space and their only hope of getting out is through the normally calm Chakotay, who is, in medical terms, completely losing his shit. Because invisible aliens, more of those, are altering his neural pathways in order to communicate with him directly. All they have done thus far, presumably, is flash a bunch of random images that have no connection. He is hallucinating at this point. And Chakotay fears out loud that he is going to end up like his grandfather that he refers to as a crazy old man.
I'm gonna end up like my grandfather, a crazy old man.
No, you're not crazy.
Now, we could debate all day about how sensitive people were to mental health issues in the 90s. But I believe when you lose someone to deterioration of the mind brought on by age or some other ailment, it's natural to have complicated feelings about it. But to have such disdain toward the afflicted for no other reason than that it happened seems pretty shitty, especially for someone that's supposed to be so enlightened and with it spiritually. Like, I would never ever say that Picard is the paragon of compassion, especially when he has fully avoided helping people using the Prime Directive. But in an episode eerily similar to this one called Night Terrors, where invisible aliens were communicating with Troy and making everybody else really tired as the ship was stuck in an anomaly, Picard talked about his grandfather succumbing to Alzheimer's, and it was one of the most touching things that Picard had shared about his family. Maybe Chakotay has a tumultuous relationship with his grandfather or unresolved issues, but he never talks about that. So Chakotay's frustration seems to be directed entirely at his grandfather being unwell before he died. Like, he blames him for it, which is pretty fucked up. This does matter, okay? I'm not just ranting like Chakotay is. The difference between Night Terrors and the fight is that the ship might actually be destroyed by the anomaly, by graviton shear, according to Milana. But because it's Voyager, we absolutely know that the ship's going to be fine the next episode, even if there's nowhere to repair it since they're stranded in the Federation-less Delta Quadrant. So the Doctor does his best Bones impression here and tells Chakotay, who is frustrated with his inability to understand these aliens fucking around with his mind, to think, man. Think back to the accident on the holodeck. The ship depends on you. So we're started in the middle and we're going back to the beginning, which has Chakotay in a boxing holodeck program with Boothby, who was a groundskeeper at Starfleet Academy, who somehow moonlighted as a boxing coach for Chakotay when he was a cadet. Boothby, I guess, is a janitor of all trades. Speaking for myself, I question his credentials, okay? Because after round three, hologram Boothby tells Chakotay, who had thus far successfully avoided being punched, which is part of the point of boxing, that he's doing it wrong. That boxing is about taking the shots and to let his opponent punch himself out.
That wasn't so bad.
It was terrible.
Am I missing something? He's not landing any punches.
That's the problem. You're not letting him.
Have I got this sport all wrong?
Boxing is more about taking the shots than dishing them out.
So he should let himself get hit, which is terrible advice. I'm not a boxing expert, but I'm pretty sure that if someone punches you in the face, it's over. Boothby even goes for the ridiculous, "But do you have the heart for this?" For what? Getting punched in the face? No one does. So why trust Boothby? He says that he knows the opponent's kind in his bones, like he knows every fracture. What the fuck does that even mean? Completely unrelated, the opponent that Chakotay is fighting bears a passing resemblance to Saru in Discovery. Just saying, I think Saru could probably kick his ass. But some odd mirror ball effect appears, which honestly reminds me of the kind of distortion that I see right before I get a migraine, which is fitting because Chakotay's momentary distraction causes him to take Boothby's advice and get punched in the face, which causes him to get knocked out. This really shouldn't happen with safety protocols in the holodeck presumably being left on, but who cares about that? Who cares? And in sickbay, the EMH gives Chakotay shit for engaging in bloody sports to begin with, and scans showed that it appeared as though he got hit with an energy weapon. Janeway asks that Chakotay come to the bridge, and the Doctor warns him that he needs to come back for scans or he's going to start seeing things.
Chakotay to the bridge.
On my way.
I want you back in here for some tests, unless you want to be seeing things on a regular basis.
Chakotay then meets Janeway on the bridge, and she's like, hey, there's some thingy out there, and we can't identify it, and it's bouncing around, and before they know it, they're inside it. Which is a valuable reminder that rounding third base on a first date just happens sometimes. 1 minute, you're watching the human centipede, just chilling, and before you know it, someone's tab A is firmly inside of someone else's slot B. Except this happens when they try to pull out which is not great. Harry Kim says that the sensors are malfunctioning in 7 of 9 in astrometrics, lets Janeway know that the Borg are familiar with this kind of anomaly, which appears randomly and unpredictably in space.
Why hasn't a Federation starship encountered anything like this?
No doubt some have.
Think of all the Starfleet vessels that disappeared under mysterious circumstances.
So it's like a Walmart DMA without the explodey part. So this is like the first episode that I have covered with 7 of 9 in it. And her character was introduced in later seasons to up the show's sex appeal. I even forgot how clingy her catsuit was. But one thing to remember is that her character is actually one of the best, if not the best, written character on Voyager, along with the Doctor. Her de-assimilation from the Borg Collective and finding herself again after being a nameless, identity-free Borg drone is a beautiful testament to human resilience. But she's basically, in this episode, just letting the crew know chaotic space is this wacky thing that the Borg knows about and only one cube has ever escaped. But once inside it, it's a ticking clock before the ship's hull is breached and destroyed. The anomaly is making sure to keep the ship going in circles while Chakotay begins to hallucinate more, starting with the boxing gloves just appearing in random places, and this somehow ends up with him on the bridge taking swings at Security Chief Tuvok. My favorite scene is back in sickbay with the Doctor, of course, who tests Chakotay's hearing by singing.
Mm-hmm. Let's go to 880 hertz.
Music lessons?
Pretty soon we'll be singing duets.
I'm checking to see if there's been any damage to the auditory nerves.
He lets Janeway know Chakotay has something called sensory tremens, a cognitive disorder that he got from his grandfather. And the genetic therapy he underwent apparently didn't quite work because the chaotic space that they're in might be triggering it. So we get this tiny moment when Chakotay's slightly vulnerable here, and he talks about how his grandfather refused medication to treat this, saying his spirit was in pain and the wound must be honored. But this still ends with Chakotay calling him a crazy old man. Also, like other stuck in anomaly episodes, Voyager discovers a ship that gives them a picture of what it'll be like if they don't get out.
It's a ship, warp capable. It's adrift, and the outer hull is damaged. No life signs.
The ship was adrift with its crew dead, and they just had log entries of people hallucinating, like Chakotay. So up until this point, with the exception of the boxing interlude, it's been a fairly garden variety, stuck in a thing Star Trek episode. But this is where it really takes a turn into what the fuckville. Population 1, Chakotay. When the Doctor says that chaotic space influences DNA and he has no cure for it, and Chakotay's response to this is, I need to go on a vision quest.
Is there a treatment?
I can control the hallucinations using a neural suppressant. But unless I can find a way to deactivate that gene of yours,
I need to go on a vision quest.
Okay. Full disclosure, once again, I am a white person and I cannot and will not dictate when and where it is appropriate to do this. But remember, so are the writers. So to have that be a solution to this kind of problem is a white guy's idea of how a native person would respond to this situation. Just keep that in mind. Janeway even grants permission to Chakotay for him to take part in his own culture.
It could agitate your mind.
Or help me control it.
Permission granted.
So it's possible that he might be able to control whatever's happening. That's his reasoning. So he gets out his chimuzi, which once again was created by the white writers, and gets cracking on that vision quest. And I'm not sure if he's lucid dreaming, but the first thing Chakotay does in this vision is argue with his grandfather.
Where are you going?
My spirit doesn't want that medicine.
I don't care what your spirit wants. You're going to take it.
And he follows him into a boxing ring, and from this vision, he knows that it's aliens talking to him, and he wakes up and he blurts out a bunch of instructions that the crew doesn't understand.
Ventrilic trajectory.
Yeah! Kelly Clarkson!
So he goes back into the vision, because I guess it's just like turning on a switch. And it's evident through the random images that he's fighting with himself and his fear, his own self-doubt, but coming out of the mouths of the crew. But what does that have to do with getting out of chaotic space? The dream takes another left, where we get this really long scene where the doctor medically describes what it's like to get punched as Neelix massages him for a really long time. Like, it's a cool performance because it's Robert Picardo. As always, even Night Terror's dream that Troy had directly to do with getting out of the anomaly, even if it was vague. But Chakotay's rapidly cycling between grandpa and boxing again, both in dreams and when he's awake. Even saying things like, nobody puts Chakotay in a corner.
Chakotay, do you know me? Do you know where you are?
I know you, Captain, but you stopped the fight. You ruined my career. Nobody's gonna put me on the card after this.
The plot even somehow goes backward in exposition when Janeway discovers stuff we already know, like chaotic space has aliens that are communicating through Chakotay. Like, the writers wrote this out of order or something.
What if those hallucinations are being induced for a purpose? Aliens who exist on some perceptual wavelength that our senses can't detect.
The aliens. They were there, watching me.
Inside your vision quest?
They were trying to tell me something.
So he goes back into the ring, or into the dream, and he finally understands the aliens in this very Onetrix Point Never plunderphonic type of way, like remixed vocals of what was already said.
Protect your head.
I understand.
We are too
alien
for you. We are too
strange
for you.
China, 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 China,
China, China, China.
And they instruct Chakotay in a way he can't directly communicate to the bridge because he doesn't quite understand it himself. He manipulates the controls and successfully gets the ship out of the anomaly. I guess this was meant to be a metaphor for facing fear, like the episode The Thaw, but also like The Thaw, it does so on the most superficial level. Chakotay could have used this vision quest to get out of the anomaly by finding peace with his grandfather's memory, or the possibility of mental illness down the road, or find more confidence in his ability to command Voyager or rely on his crew. But none of those things happen. Chakotay's character does not develop at all as a result of this. All of those symbols and interactions are just window dressing and obstacles to get around to get the message from the aliens. It was just the weird rearranged vocals that gave him the clue to get out. The fight isn't satisfying. It doesn't mean anything. They get stuck, they get out, they move on. So it's completely skippable. Like, subscribe, no pressure, but peer pressure. Till next time, I guess.